Hello, Dr. Urban here, and I want to talk to you about a situation or process called autophagy, along with mitophagy, autophagy and stress, autophagy and fasting, and the autophagy lysosome. So what is autophagy? Well, think of the individual cell in your body. It might be in the pancreas, it might be in the brain, it might be in the heart. Just picture an individual cell. Well, it's got stuff in it. But what happens when that cell is injured or there's something going on that the cell needs to, which is not beneficial to the cell? That could be a virus. It could be a broken down mitochondrion. But anyway, you get the picture. Well, the autophagy means to self-eat or auto-digest. And it's a good term. It's called the second immune system, which ordinarily lies dormant unless it's activated by severe stress such as fasting or aerobic exercise in the extreme. But we can activate this second immune system. So what happens? It's like trash day. The cell has autophagy genes. These are genes just like any other genes, and they're activated under stress and not activated or not very much activated without stress. And what the purpose is to clean up the trash that would be broken down mitochondria, proteins, maybe even a virus inside the cell, and it can put a vesicle around these bodies and move them to a trash station that's really a recycle center called a lysosome. A lysosome is a vesicle, but the beautiful part is it can take not just simple molecules, it can take things like viruses, it can take whole mitochondria that aren't working. Yay, and what happens? It takes the good material from this debris and recycles it. And that's kind of the essence of autophagy. Fasting and autophagy work together because fasting, after beginning at a point, tends to kick in, and therefore cells can be renewed, or new cells can come along. So that's a good deal. Now we're talking about cells everywhere: cells in the brain, cells in the pancreas, stuff like this, where function can be restored because the body is determined to stay in shape and survive through autophagy. So anyway, you kind of get the picture. What do? Well, intermittent fasting is one way to do it if extreme strenuous aerobic exercise is not for you, then fasting. And it turns out that something like a 16-hour fast could be less in some people, could be more in others, but 16 should get you started. Fast kicks in autophagy. Well, how do you do this? Here's what I do. I don't eat breakfast. I stop eating after 6 o'clock. That satisfies a couple of parameters about sleeping and autophagy. And so you see, if when I wake up, I'm probably sitting at 12, 13 hours. And if I don't eat breakfast, and then I eat lunch, I'm at my 16, 17 hours, and I'm in the autophagic zone. So think about that. Now, how do you break a fast? You break a fast with carbs and fats and proteins, just like anything else. There is a discussion about taking ketones, but I don't take anything until I'm ready for the fast to be broken. So I do this daily. And I think I'm making new cells that are better with all of the consequences. So give it a try. Autophagy and fasting come together and work together, and you will activate genes that are very beneficial and new cells.